a long time. Out here from cloud nine, she be looking pretty like a flower.
Looking so fine.
And every time she smile, make me wanna walk for miles. Everything around her lights up with a shine.
Matango hese ma.
To the 2022 SANPIG Specific Peoples Awards. Well, it is fabulous to see you all here in person at the 7th SANPIG Specific Peoples Awards. Our Pacific communities have stayed safe, and we are so grateful to all of our Pacific people across the board at MIQ, the health providers, supermarkets, and at the border.
Aloha, Pito.
And now, before we give out the awards, we'd like to welcome to the stage the Minister for Pacific Peoples, Minister Aupito, William Seor, to say a few words.
It's been a long time coming together like this after a tumultuous past 2 years. Pacific peoples, we have faced challenges, but collectively we've been able to keep ourselves safe, vibrant and resilient. Tonight we're going to see the acknowledgement of individuals. You'll see their energy, you'll see their leadership that they bring to areas such as youth, health and education, all essential to our Pacific well-being. There is a group that we will recognise tonight, and that is the Pacific workforce at the managed isolation and quarantine facilities. These are the people who, at the border in Mangere, put their lives on the line while you and I slept safely throughout the nights. These are the people that kept us safe. Finally, I just want to say, let this evening be a delicious evening for everyone here tonight.
Whaftai te lelava, Honourable Minister, and this year, we are very fortunate, hau eki pe mui kāinga, to have a platinum sponsor in the Ministry of Business, Innovation and Employment. So I'd now like to invite Mal Porter, Deputy Secretary for MBIE, to come up and address you all.
Tēnā koutou katoa and warm Pacific greetings. What a special occasion this is to celebrate the spirit of Pasifika community and impact. I'm here today representing Hikina Whakatutuki, the Ministry of Business, Innovation and Employment, commonly known as MBIE. On behalf of MBIE, I'd like to extend our most sincere and heartfelt thanks to our Pacific workers and Pacific providers and the healthcare workforce who contributed to the success of MIQ and the success of the COVID-19 response. I think everybody here is all extremely proud of the work that you've done and the contribution to the community that has enabled us all to be here in this room tonight to celebrate Pasifika excellence. Le whaamau moe sa whauau, whaupō, le neiwatau nuu, mo moli la au I whongaa, soifua mai amanuia.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Madame, Monsieur, it's time to give out some awards. Our first award this evening will be the ProCare Top Pacific Nurse Award. Please welcome Te Vita Funaki from the ProCare Health Board Chair to the stage. Pas pas mai, malo.
Kia ora tātou whānau, malelele te alafalawa Nissan Bulawinaka and warm Pacific greetings. This is a great chance for us to recognise the important contributions they play within our communities, and particularly for our Pacific families. It is my honour on behalf of ProCare and as the Chair of ProCare Health Board to announce the winner of the first Top Pacific Nurse Award, Imelda Urokorua.
So Mbula Vinaka, I'm Imelda. I'm from Fiji, the beautiful islands of Vanuatu. Currently working at Waitakere Hospital at the Assessment, Treatment and Rehab Ward. I chose nursing because I love helping people. That compassion, you know, having that empathy for your patients, some of us, we need to build that in with our practice, to build that rapport as well. Very challenging. I had to get out of my comfort zone as well and, you know, be able to speak up more. I couldn't think of myself, I had to put them first so I could make their stay at the hospital, you know, in our ward as comfortable as possible. I would say my family keeps me sane. Spending time with them, going for family walks, for me that keeps me grounded. It gives me a fresh new start for the next day, prepare myself mentally as well, and nature, just enjoying nature. I love the patients. They give me that reason, you know, to look forward to. Just talking with them, bringing them a smile to their face, having the odd joke. Just having the ideal amount of people, just having a full staff for each shift, having the stock available ready so you don't have to go running around getting things off different wards. I would say time as well, ideally. It's rewarding. We are making a difference in someone's life and, you know, you never know, it could make a difference in your life as well.
Kia ora, Miss Sambula Vinaka. I am so humbled to receive this award on behalf of my family, and there are a lot of people I would like to acknowledge. First and foremost, I would like to acknowledge God, because without him, I would not be here today. Secondly, my parents for leaving Fiji to start a new life in New Zealand, to better their lives and open opportunities for my siblings and I. Thank you, Mom and Dad. The head of School of Healthcare and Social Practice of Unitec, Mrs. Linda Amua, my lecturers in Unitec, Pacific Learning Advisor, Mrs. Daisy Bentley Gray, and fellow colleagues that we have shared the last 3 years together, the tears, the long study nights, the laughter. Alia, thank you for being here. A special mention goes out to the dear nursing lecturer of mine, Mrs. Anna Smith, may her soul rest in peace. Lastly, but not definitely the least, my precious sons, Basil Ebenezer, and my amazing husband, Isai Rokua. Thank you so much for standing by me and supporting me along the way through my disappointments and frustrations, for always reminding me to celebrate the small achievements and always take each day as it comes. Vinaka Vakalevu.
Amusia piae matahina okune yangi faiteria kae ho.
First category of the night is the Ministry of Education Pacific Education Award. We now welcome Isabel Evans, Deputy Secretary at the Ministry of Education.
Nisambula Vinaka and warm Pacific greetings. It's great to be here this evening to celebrate the wonderful contributions and achievement of our Pacific people in Aotearoa, New Zealand. The Ministry of Education is proud to sponsor the Pacific Education Award. From early learning through to tertiary, This category recognises Pacific contributions to improving Pacific communities' educational achievement and success. On behalf of the Ministry of Education, I congratulate tonight's winners of the Pacific Education Award, and I also congratulate all the organisations and individuals that work tirelessly to improve education outcomes for Pacific young people in Aotearoa, New Zealand. Vanaka Vakalevu.
Our first recipient was the inaugural director of the Pacific Studies Department, Ma'au Manu Basifika. She also established the postgraduate Talanoa National Seminar Series. She's held posts with the UN Development Fund for Women and the UN Development Fund in the Pacific. She served as chair of the Health Research Council Pacific Team, as well as social sciences committees of both the Royal Society, Te Aparangi, and UNESCO. The first recipient of the Ministry of Education Education Award is Emeritus Professor Tangaloa Tele Peggy Fairbairn Dunlop.
Talofa lava, Tangaloa Tele Peggy Fairbairn Dunlop from Tananga Manono, and a bit of Whasi To'o and a bit of Litongo. When I was growing up, education, going to teachers' college or going to be a dental nurse, that was about the only avenues open for women, really. Teaching was sort of the logical thing that quite a few Samoans, I think, do pretty well. The values which we learn at home about caring for each other and looking after each other, they just naturally follow into the teaching learning process. I think it's all about relationships, isn't it? The way caring for students and listening to students and trying to make your whatever you do so interesting and important that they will get your message and then question your message. Not so good, but actually there's nothing better in the world when someone questions you. The students of today are actually starting to stand up and call the bias for what it was. And our parents, we've got a new generation of parents coming through who are standing up for their children. They are standing up for them. They are getting on boards of trustees. They're getting on all these positions and they're learning the processes by which we can deal with the hurts that in the past we just took them. That's our hopes for our future Pacific children, that they can walk down the street with their head high and people understand where they're coming from, and we're able to talk about that in a meaningful way.
Yeah, tate avele moa le tua, ilona lofa, malanga angalele e mafena mafa chasile nei putuputunga. I'm probably the oldest person getting the award today, and it seems that I've been in education for years. All right. But I guess just a couple of things I would like to say. I've actually taught from early childhood education right through to postgraduate. And I want to say that teaching is such an honourable career, really. And we're all doing it all the time, aren't we? In sports teams, wherever we go, Sunday school, choir, formal and community education, we are actually passing on messages all the time. So really, I want to thank all the many students I've taught for years and years and years. I'm so proud of them. And we've had such joy together, actually. I've learned a lot from them, and hopefully they've learned a bit from me. I guess right now I should say thank you to our parents who migrated from Samoa with five children and had another two children here in New Zealand, and I'm one of those ones. I thank my husband. I thank my five stroppy, beautiful daughters who have always supported everything I have done, right or wrong, and been by my side. Thank you very much to you all.
What's up, Sina? Oh, what's up, Sina?
Well, our next recipient has been a lecturer in Va'au Manu Pasifika at Victoria University for the past 10 years. He completed his PhD in 2020, in which his doctoral thesis examined Samoan text-based language change during the years 1906 to 2014. His breadth and depth of Indigenous Samoan knowledge and passion for Samoan language and culture has seen him author the first book titled Launga, Understanding Samoan Oratory. Our next recipient of the Ministry of Education Pacific Education Award is Le'au Sali Law, Dr. Sadat Muayava.
Fa'atal fa'atu, ma'alol soifua, ia olo ingoa, my name is Sadat Muayava. I otisau mainu o falise la, masa fa'ato ai lefanga, pefo ie fenga, lotofanga, falilatai, lufi-lufi, asau, ia masa leola, ma'alol soifua. Pacific Studies allowed me to just be me, be Samoan in the tertiary space. Pacific Studies also allowed me to learn, relearn, even rethink Pacific history. There was a lot of sense of empowerment as well, to be able to empower and see Pacific history and learn about it through a Pacific lens. The knowledge is our knowledge, and it's Indigenous knowledge, and it's local knowledge, and so the best stories and the truth in that knowledge, we hold that. And so I think it's really important that the tertiary space and institutions look at that knowledge. And so I've tried to pass that to my students as well, those who come through the doors into my classrooms. I think there's a lot of change in Pacific education, and a lot of people have worked really hard to be able to see our knowledge as being valued in institutions, but I still feel like there's still a long way to go, especially in the tertiary institution. So in the work that I do in the next 10 years, I'd like to see our oral traditions being recognised and acknowledged as spoken research, spoken journal articles, because the knowledge that we speak are all part of research and life experiences that we've gathered all our lives. And so that's valid research.
Au te tūlei atu le ava mali whaaloalo, ina nei fwoi tūlau le afiafi, whaatulo watu pa ia maolunga nei afiafi, pa ia whaa tala lelei, pa ia whaa le malo, pa ia whaa le atu no utulou. I'm not sure if Tangalo Tele remembers, but I was in her master's paper, and she was my lecturer down at Ra'umanu, so I'm not sure if she remembers me tonight, but I certainly do remember her. I'll keep it short. To me, when thinking about education, I'd like to think that we are members of numerous whale, residences and homes and spaces. So I dedicate this award to the many whale that I have been blessed to be born into and be a member of. I'd like to acknowledge my parents as well, Reverend Alda Malaki Moiava and my mum, Losa Lili Moiava, father-in-law Sitama Tupuola Chadwick, and mum Katie Chadwick, who is, although not with us here in person, but is definitely here with us in spirit. My family who are here tonight, Tui Moiava Toso, Singafulava Chadwick, and Kate Chadwick, my sister Te, and her husband Fatiala, to my beautiful wife Shana, and also our kids back in Wellington, Fafte Telelava. It's my 41st birthday today. So it couldn't have been a more fitting evening to receive this award. Last but not least, look out for my next book, Fa'alawe Lawe, Fa'aftai Manuel Po.
Sing the bell, bell.
ladies and gentlemen, ohana. Our second category is the Pasifika Futures Pacific Health and Wellbeing Award. Now, to present this award, please welcome to the stage from Pasifika Futures, Jerry Yelamia. Pats pats mai.
Pasifika Futures, the Whānau Ora Commissioning Agency for Pasifika Families, is proud to support the SunPeaks Awards and to sponsor the Pacific Health and Wellbeing Award. In the past 2 years, Pacific families up and down the country have reached out for help, and our communities and our ecosystem of Pacific leaders, Pacific organizations have responded. The awards tonight honors more of the heroes of our community who work tirelessly every day for Pacific families because the job is not done yet. On behalf of Pacific Futures, we congratulate all the finalists and recipients of tonight, and we are proud to present the SunPeaks Award for Pacific Health and Wellbeing. Whakamalo, ai whaftailasi.
Our next awardee is our Hawke's Bay Pacific Health Manager, who championed their Pacific COVID response working directly with our community, church leaders, our health council, civil defence, iwi, welfare leads, and he also led flu immunisations and COVID testing outreach in church settings in 2020. His passion, leadership and tireless work for Pasifika whānau across the Hawke's Bay has contributed immeasurably to community health and well-being and promoting inclusive communities. Ladies and gentlemen, hoʻē ki te kāinga, the first winner of the Pasifika Futures Pacific Health and Wellbeing Award is Tofilau Talalele Taufale.
Talofa lava. I'm Tofilau Talalele Taufale. I'm from the villages of Iwa, Falelatai and Lutuanu in Samoa. I was born and raised in Wellington, and for the last 25 years I've lived in Hawke's Bay, and now I'm the RAC interim national lead, as well as a Pacific voice in the primary care pathways, Talanoa. As a Pacific health manager in Hawke's Bay, we knew that there was going to be a lockdown, and so I took the opportunity to coordinate with some of our Pacific leaders and some of our other Pacific staff that work across other sectors to come together and lay a foundation for us to work together to support the community moving forward, knowing that we were going to go into a lockdown. Over the years, I've been really fortunate to have great role models, so I've been exposed to great leadership, and what that looks like, and all the forms of leadership that I've been exposed to have been different. So some might be values-based, some might be outcomes-based, some might be win at all costs, but I've been able to learn from that to help shape me moving forward. I have huge aspirations for our community in terms of home ownership, in terms of business opportunities, in terms of opportunities in the trades. I see a strong need for more Pacific in this space, not just as workers, but as leaders, collectively as communities and as services and agencies. If we lift our view and look forward, there's a bright future for us all.
Talofa lava, everyone, and a warm Hawke's Bay greeting to you all. When I was announced a winner of this award, I was really surprised, and the first thing I thought about was bringing my team here, and I'm absolutely proud of them. I want to also acknowledge our community leaders, because without our community leaders, this wouldn't have been possible. I want to acknowledge that they were able to sit down around the table with me, put our cards on the table, and work together for the betterment of our people. What better example could I ask of our leaders to lead by our actions and not our words? So I'm grateful for them. I'm grateful for the iwi as well, because they gave us the opportunity to have a space and we could strengthen our relationships, and they could honour us in what we do by giving us the space to do that. Finally, I acknowledge my parents, came like many to New Zealand for a better living for their families. To my wife, Miriam, and my kids, they ended up working in clinics as well. Without you, this wouldn't have been possible. The issues that we faced as a family during those times were turbulent, but together we got through. Whaftai te lava.
Now, the second recipient of the Pasifika Futures Pacific Health and Wellbeing Award has worked as a dietitian, nutritionist, consultant, and also director. She's worked as a dietitian and nutritionist for the Ministry of Health, the Kingdom of Tonga, South Seas Healthcare, and consultant for ProCare Health Limited. She has just completed her Doctorate of Philosophy in Health Science at Auckland University of Technology. Our next Pasifika Futures Pacific Health and Wellbeing Award winner is Dr. Soana Muimuiheata.
Maloilele, my name is Soana Muimuiheata. My father is from Folaha in Nuketulu, and my mother is from Eua in Kolomotua. I'm a dietitian consultant, and I have my own company, which is called the Total Wellbeing Consultancy Services Limited. I have always been interested in health. When I grew up, my mom had diabetes or heart disease. So every time we rush here to the hospital, I always look at people and I say, these are people who come and help my mother. I want to help somebody else in the future. My motivation is to help somebody, to add values for their life. And I know with the health and well-being of our people, with the nutrition-related diseases that we have, somehow we need to understand the connection between the food and our health condition. The most satisfying of my career is when somebody tell me the things that they couldn't do, but when they make a change of their eating or their lifestyle, and they share big improvement in their clinical outcomes, that's what's satisfying. We need to take more of the services to the community and involve them right from the beginning and allow them to share their stories. In the Western world, we have a structured care that doesn't allow flexibility to be able for people to be motivated and be themselves until we provide space for people to be comfortable, safe, share their stories. That's when people make a change. Everybody wants to be healthy.
Mālo sisu, o tua motonga koho kutofia. I'm honoured to receive this award at this important stage of my journey. My stories, I have so much to be thankful for. I am forever grateful. O ku hounga kia te au sisu, I kai te kelia kia wataini. I would like to acknowledge my parents, who has raised in love. My father, Sione Muimuiheata, of Folaha e Nuketulu. My mother, Salote Manumei Pulotu, Muimuiheata of Ohonua, Kolomaile, Tufuwai Ewa, Kolomotua, Wahao. To the Tongan community, to the Pacific people, to New Zealand society, I am grateful for the opportunity to be able to serve you. To the health providers who provide clinical space for me to practice. Last but not least, to my family. To my sister, Popua, and my sisters. To my brother, Sione Niu and Futa. To my nieces and my nephew, who supported me through. Thank you, everyone, for being part of my life. Mālo sisu tu au fatu.
Our next category is the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade Pacific Enterprise Award. We'd like to now invite to the stage Felicity Bolland, the Director for Pacific Connections at MFAT.
Kia rana and warm Pacific greetings. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade is delighted to be able to recognise the significant contributions our Pacific people are making in the private sector, and we are thrilled to be presenting the Enterprise Award this evening to two very deserving entrepreneurs. Kia rana. our first recipient has created a space in the business sector to support Pacific businesses to grow and thrive and increase employment opportunities for Pacific people. All of their services are tailored and designed for Pacific businesses, and for the last 2 years in a row, they've provided a pop-up Pasifika event for Pacific businesses who were impacted by the cancellation of the Pasifika Festival. The first winner of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade Pacific Enterprise Award is Laura Kyle Hall from the Pacific Business Hub.
My name is Laura Kyle Hall, and I was born and raised in Samoa from the villages of Tuanaimato, Tulaele, Pesinga, and my great-grandfather from Lotofanga. I am the founder and the CEO of the Pacific Business Hub. The journey started 10 years ago at BNZ when I was working there as a business manager. And what I found was there was no Pacific businesses that I could actually refer business to. There was a lack of support in general for Pacific businesses. There was no place where our people can go to and conduct their business activities. So I wanted to build that for Pacific businesses and entrepreneurs. For us, it's building a community that uplifts each other and supporting each other. The most gratifying part of this journey is being able to help our people achieve their dreams in owning businesses and becoming entrepreneurs. Many of them that come through our doors are too scared or don't have the confidence or don't believe in themselves. So what we're saying, you don't have to feel that way. We have this space for you. We're accessible anytime if you need us. What I would like to see is for the different Pacific organizations or stakeholders in business to come together and work together. We got to look at the bigger picture. I feel there's a huge market out there for every one of us, and we all can get that piece of the pie.
Thank you, Lord, for blessing me with a vision and using me as an instrument of your love to serve you and to serve your people in providing a space to enable and empower our Pacific businesses and entrepreneurs. This one is for you. I would like to take this opportunity to thank my husband, Walter, sitting over there. I may be the face of the Pacific Business Hub, but he is very much part of the business and has the utmost important job of looking after our kids. To my kids, Winona, Shelby, and boss baby Willow, thank you for your patience and understanding these past few years. Mom loves you. To my siblings, I am grateful for your love and support over the years. Although my parents are no longer with us, I am grateful for the upbringing that I had in Samoa. And to all our Pacific businesses and entrepreneurs, keep hustling, keep grinding, and never give up. Faftai.
Congratulations, Laura. Our second awardee operates a business that sells a premium Pacific Islands product and celebrates Gava culture in a pan-Pacific approach that is accessible to people of all backgrounds. The premises is a learning space and a cultural crossroads where people can meet, drink kava, and have conversations with each other in an exclusive and alcohol-free environment. The next winner of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade is the founder and director of Four Shells Kava Lounge, Anau Mesui Henry.
My name is Anau Mesui Henry, and I come from the villages of Kaimeli, Vava'u, Kolomotu'a, Tataka Motonga, and our family home is in Longolongo. Kava's always been in the blood. Our bread and butter was kava growing up. That was just part of surviving here in Aotearoa. And I guess deep down inside, I always wanted to extend that story just as a way of keeping, you know, the memories of the sacrifices of my parents alive. So we chose to go with kava. A big part of what we do is just changing narratives, like redefining the narrative of who we are as Tongan, who we are as Tongan business people, where we do business, how do we look, And it'll be awesome to see the community, you know, right across Aotearoa, just be open to learn more about gawa, how gawa can be like a meaningful tool to facilitate good conversation and good relationships. Usually if I'm not working here, I'm working on something else, but I've intentionally decided to just stop and focus on the children in case I go home and they don't know who I am. Yeah, so trying to slow down. But my dad always said, you know, you don't sleep until you're dead, and I agree with him. We follow the whakawe kaula that underpins what we do, you know, whakaapaapa, mamahi I mea, tauhi wā, lototo. And those principles, we bring it into just who we are and how we carry ourselves. In terms of like our principles around and values around doing whai kawa, we just operate on like a human to human level. Being thankful, me saying that is not even enough to really capture just how grateful we are for the community. I feel like, you know, the shop is more, it's not just us, it's like everyone. If it wasn't for everyone supporting, and that's really, really enabled us to carry on.
Malalele, si Otaofa, malalau ma lia hau eiki, mai ka inga Tonga, mai ka inga Pasifiki hono kotoa. Kau kolepe ke malumalu atu I he whakatapu hono kotoa, ka ata moau ke uwhaha ki I lea, whakamalo nou nou. Kia ora everyone, what's up? Man, what an amazing privilege to stand here right now, really, eh? I was just drinking gawa and next minute here I am. So this award is to my beautiful parents, ne nisi me sui sione atiai, ko ofa lahi atka maua, I kai ha lea whiunga ke atka maua, ke talaku ofa, mo ku whakamalo, I ngahi ako naki kotoa pena mo whaiki mo ui, ko ofa lahi atka maua. This is so wonderful to just be amongst all the leaders here tonight, Brown Excellence at its finest, who would have thought? And to all my dear mates here, table 20, thank you for being here, guys. And lastly, to my kids, I've got my children, two of them here. Ngata Tonga Mata Moana, Ileini Anake Sina, my twins at home. This one's for you. And I hope you grow up and do better things than me. This award really wouldn't be possible if it wasn't for my right-hand man, you know, my ride and die, my pee in the same pod, my offa'anga, Todd Marble Henry, all the way from Pennsylvania, America. What can I say? They say that behind every strong man is a stronger woman. In our case, it really is true. So I just want to say, thank you so much for putting up with me and the patience. That's why your hair's all gray, but that's okay, you know? Ofa lahiat ga mau tolu, and thank you for being here, everyone.
Now to the successors, the young burgeoning leaders. Here to present the Lewa Pacific Emerging Leadership Award is Asia Paeo Va'afusuanga, Lewa Youth Rep, with Lewa CE Denise Kingi Uluave. Paspaspai.
On behalf of our Chief Executive, Denise Kingi Uluave, Lewa is honoured to support the 2022 SunPix Awards, specifically the Pacific Emerging Leadership Award. Leadership is measured through the growth of our people, and this award celebrates Pacific leadership that is creating foundations for our future. The Pacific Emerging Leadership Award celebrates individuals who represent this in their entirety and embodies Lewa's purpose, which is to support Pasifika communities to unleash their full potential. So, to our award winners and your villagers, we thank you for your service and we celebrate you tonight.
Our first recipient is a proud New Zealand-born Samoan raised in Ōtara. She is part of UN Youth New Zealand and has held various roles, with her current one being Auckland Regional President for 2021. She also sits on the 2021 New Zealand-US Embassy Youth Council. Through this, she has introduced high school students to civics, ensured Māori and Pasifika rangatahi voices were being amplified, and encouraged them to become active citizens in their communities. Our first winner of the Le Wā Pacific Emerging Leadership Award is Viola Tauti.
Talofalava, I'm Oloingo o Viola Tauti. I'm Samoan and I was born and raised here in Ōtara. My mom comes from the villages of Ngofuali'i, Samatau and Falilatai, and my dad comes from the villages of Batsamia and Nifangoli'i. So I'm currently working full-time at a non-profit called Multi-Ethnic Young Leaders New Zealand. And I study a Bachelor of Global Studies at the University of Auckland. So my majors are Human Rights and Global Politics, doing an area study of the Pacific Islands and Samoan language. Lately, I've been doing a lot of work that focuses around like international relations, and I think my goals career-wise is to serve the Pacific community. My style of leadership centers around service. Other than service would be, I guess, empathy. I guess open-minded and understanding of like other people's lived experiences. So I learned that just by watching my parents, just watching them like serve their communities and how it links around people. So just thinking about how we can make people's lives a lot easier and also equitable. I'd like to see, I guess, just more equity being applied to like the Pacific communities here in New Zealand, but also worldwide, just for better livelihoods.
Mō moana si I alewinga lea tōi lona lofa māngu nei. I want to acknowledge my parents, who are my blueprint from my belief systems, values, and what servant leadership looks like. I learned it all from them, and for them, I thank them for all their sacrifices and for letting me step out of the pathway that they're familiar with and explore what's out there. I also want to acknowledge my spiritual parents, Mawhala and Lalokawa Lima, who are here with me tonight, and also to my sister and her husband, my brother-in-law, who are also here, and for being my Uber drivers for the last few months. Working in the youth space in the last few years has been a huge privilege. As we all know, these systems that have a huge role in our everyday lives, they aren't always accommodating for us, where we could be in a safe, equitable and thriving society. But regardless of the barriers they face, I see our youth defy the odds and still find joy in the simple things. This award is not mine alone, but it's yours as well. Baptize your lover.
The next winner of the Le Wā Pacific Emerging Leadership Award has been a Sistema Aotearoa tutor, Mangere Youth MP, and was the string orchestra leader and prefect at Mount Roskill Grammar. She participated and led the KBB Honours Festival and is also an active member of The Hive. This year, she was the lead organiser for Young Labour Pasifika and is currently working as the MP support to Honourable Aupito William Seal since 2021. The next winner of the Le Wā Pacific Emerging Leadership Award is Ala Kihihifo Vailala. Pas pas mai.
Malalele kokingoa ko alaki fo vailala. My mother is from Fo'ui and Haveluloto, and my father is from Kolomotu'a, Homa Ewa, and Golo Hapai. My biggest achievement would definitely have to be when I was 17, I decided to pack my bags and move to Tonga to teach voluntarily at Dailulu College. I taught violin. I usually just work and work, and it's not until you see that kids who would have never dreamed of playing violin to be able to play a couple songs in front of their parents and, you know, be proud. That's the most satisfying thing to me. The important qualities to making a good leader, I believe, number one is empathy. You have to understand the people that you're leading in order to be successful in leading them. Also, being a compassionate leader, people can approach you for advice and also makes it easier for you to pass on and share that knowledge that you may have that others may want. I'm motivated and inspired by my maternal grandparents, who were the true epitome of, in order to lead, you must serve. They definitely motivated and inspired me into how I hold myself, but also how I do things now. I'd love to see more youth take risks, get out of their comfort zone, try new things out. Even if you think it might not be what you want to do, you never know, it might be. But I'd also like to see more healing happening within our next generations.
Throughout my life, I've been blessed with the best village that has made me into the person I am today. I give credit to our Pacific communal obligations, and thus why in every success, I honour my Tongan culture. I'd like to give a special thanks to my family, my mom, my dad, my sisters and my auntie Whane and Makone, who could be with us tonight. Thank you for all endless support and love you've shown along the way. My amazing friends, teachers and colleagues, both in New Zealand and Tonga. Loved ones who are no longer here. My grandparents, the late Devita and Alaki Fo'afu, survivors of the Dawn Raids and who were epitome of leadership through service. A special mention to my mentors, the Honourable Aupito William Seal, along with Le Maunga Lydia Sosene. Thank you so much for always believing in me and always reminding me to carry my culture with pride in everything I do. Lastly, to all emerging young Pasifika leaders out there, like the words of my mentor, the Honourable Aupito William Seal, you are brown, beautiful, brainy, bilingual, bicultural and bold. But if you're from Mangere, you're also bloody brilliant. Mala Aupito, ofatu.
Our next award is the Whamak Te Pātaka Whaioranga Pacific Service Excellence Award. This is awarded to an organisation that makes an important contribution to Pacific communities in their work. From Te Pātaka Whaioranga Whamak, we are joined by Deputy Chair of Te Pātaka Whaioranga Whamak Board, Dr Claudia Wees.
Whawhatai marama for the lovely introduction, and tēnā koutou katoa. Soifua Manuia, and greetings to this auspicious, wonderful attendees of this amazing event tonight. It's been so inspiring for me personally, and I am really deeply indebted to all of you. And it is my honour and privilege to represent Te Pātaka Whaioranga Whamak and its board this evening as Deputy Chair. Te Pātaka Whaioranga recognises the importance of this award and the work people do to contribute to improve the health, well-being and outcomes of Pacific peoples, and recognises the alignment of our work to ensure Pacific peoples access to medicines and medical devices to improve their own health and well-being. Friends and family, this evening we would like to congratulate the winners of the SunPix Pacific Service Excellence Awards for 2022.
And the first winner of the Te Pātaka Whaioranga Whamak Pacific Service Excellence Award is a program which has empowered, uplifted, transformed and reminded Pasifika leaders across Aotearoa of their importance, their identity, perspective, lived experience and voice in mainstream spaces. This program has had a profound impact on all those who have participated in it. The first winner of the Te Pātaka Whai Oranga Whamak Pacific Service Excellence Award is Mana Moana.
My name is Carlo Mila, but my whānau is the Uluwabe whānau, and we come from Kolofa'o. My grandmother comes from Wofu. I think because I grew up in Pāmi, with the Tongan dad, Balangi mum, I didn't feel like I belonged anywhere. And so I guess I was just always trying to understand, who are we, where are we from? So I did my PhD looking at who we were as New Zealand-born Pacific people. One of the findings of that was if we felt accepted, if we were proud of our culture, if the values were still important to us, then we're in a much, much stronger position. And that's why I researched and created Mana Moana. Meaning and belonging means so much to us. And I was like, well, how do we do that? Especially when we're really far from, you know, our home islands and stuff. And so I wanted to create an experience for people where they can explore and better connect to their ancestral legacy and feel really connected. And if we can kind of clean up what's in our family lines and address the big problems, the big entanglements, and not pass it down, like for me, that's the work of our lives. Right now, Mana Moana is making some ripples, but I'd like to see it make waves. I'd like to see it grow as a movement and people that are called to it, that they can train in it and pass it on. So just bigger splash, I suppose.
Tulo, tulo, tulo. Forgive me for choosing to read a poem, a short poem. I want to read this to honour my family, my friends, the Mana Moana whānau, and all of you who have received awards tonight. It's called Mātou Mana Moana. We have all travelled through the bodies of so many ancestors to arrive here, this place, time and space, all of us wearing those who have passed away on our faces. We are the next waves of a tide that has been coming for a long time. So let us follow the ocean roads that lead us via the stars to the expansion of each other. And if we make mistakes on the shore, let us rectify this in the deep ocean. Let us steer through the storms, for our leaders have always been determined on the high seas. In times of darkness, let us dare to shine and have no fear about shining too brightly. Resist the dimming and dumbing down of low expectations. It does not serve your families. It does not serve our communities. It does not serve Aotearoa. Let each of us find that place where we have most to give, where we will be of most service, and resist those things that we fear and those people who fear us when we are at our most powerful. When the journey is too hard, let us tie our outriggers to each other and share breath. Let us heed the words of our ancestors, for the mātou, the hooks in your hands, which you use to cast your dreams, are hewed from the jawbones of your tupuna. What do they want you to catch in this lifetime? What do you want your mokopuna to catch in theirs? You are the thread between what has been before and what will come as long as you have breath. We have so much to remember. We have so much to learn. We have so much to teach. Let us serve. Mālo.
Next recipient of the Te Pātaka Whai Oranga Whamak Pacific Service Excellence Award goes to an organisation that exemplifies Pacific excellence driven by Pacific ethos and model of practice to bring evidence wellbeing solutions inclusive of the community and for Pacific communities. Their work transcends the Pacific voice from the whale to the beehive ensuring Pacific wellbeing thrives. The second winner of the Te Pātaka Whai Oranga Pharmac Pacific Service Excellence Award goes to Moana Connect.
Malai Tongia, Jacinta Whalilifido, CEO of Moana Connect. In July, we rebranded as Moana Connect, and that was because we were doing a lot of research, evaluation work, just through the dynamic approach to research and the way we engaged with our communities. We found that it had to lead to lots more interventions and projects with our communities and partnership initiatives. We were doing a lot of lecturing, running workshops, and really helping to translate some of that research into information that we can pass on to our communities. That led to our learning waka. So we now have three service waka, which is Moana Research, Moana Learning, and Moana Community. We draw on a lot of our pioneers who, you know, laid the pathway for Pacific research approaches, so much so that we've named all of our rooms and spaces after a lot of their work, because that helps to ground us and reminding us of the way we should do research that is reciprocal and that ultimately does lead to change for our families. One of the things we want to keep doing is really drawing on that genuine partnership model with our communities, strengthening family and community systems, because a lot of the work that we do, we feel very accountable for, especially around the research findings and recommendations. If there was definitely one thing I could change, it's making housing affordable for everybody and ensuring sufficient income for our children.
We've all come up because we all wanted to be together. Don't you all look so beautiful? Thank you. We're very honoured. We started off with six and we're now 26. And one of the great things with Moana Connect is we've created a way for young students, postgrads, undergrads, creatives to be able to work in the community doing research, which really helps. We are committed to elevating the stories and experiences of Pacific families and communities. Our mission is to ensure that Pacific voices are heard and that change happens. Can I thank our families? None of us could do this work without our husbands and our wives and our children and our grandchildren and our grandparents. We could not do the work we do without our families.
All right, to our final awards of the night. This is the Ministry for Pacific Peoples Pacific Community Leadership Award. We welcome to the stage Tuau Pepe Abafido, Acting Secretary and Chief Executive from the Ministry for Pacific Peoples, with Minister Aupito William Seal.
Talofalava, it is humbling and an honour for this ministry to support the Pacific Community Leadership Award, a category which recognises those Pacific people who lead community organisations for the betterment of our communities. We thank and congratulate both of this year's Pacific Community Leaders Award winners. Mā lo whakatai.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first recipient of the Ministry for Pacific Peoples Pacific Community Leadership Award hails from Oamaru. She has continued the work of the Oamaru Pacific Islands Network alongside as a forum to support inter-agency collaboration for initiatives to support Pacific people in the Waitaki District. She has just been re-elected as a councillor for the Waitaki District Council, and it is with great pleasure that I introduce, ladies and gentlemen, the first recipient of the Ministry for Pacific Peoples Pacific Community Leadership Award is Hana Halalele.
I
Warm Pacific greetings. My name is Hannah Halalele. My role is General Manager for the Oamaru Pacific Island Community Group, and I'm also a councillor for the Waitaki District Council. My mum, she's from Mota'a in Waie'e, and my late father is from Sala'imoa. My family moved here in the mid-1980s, and there were only a handful of Pasifika families here in those days. So we banded together just to support each other. Then they created the Oamaru Pasifika Women's Branch. And under that was the umbrella of the Oamaru Pacific Island Cultural Group and the Language Nest, now known as the Oamaru Pacific Community Group. Our organisation, we deliver a range of social services for our Pasifika and our wider community, whether it's been mentoring support to help them into work or employment or training, or just to help them realise what their potential is. I think that's one of the most satisfying experiences that we have, and we're here to serve the community. We always stay on purpose and using our Pasifika values in terms of alofa, tautua, service, respect for alo alo, and just incorporating, you know, like even the four pillars into everything that we do, ensuring that we embed Pasifika models of care across everything that we do. We don't always see ourselves as leaders, we're just here to serve the community and get our messaging across, especially with other agencies and councils and things, to lobby for the support for our community, but also doing it with a bit of humility and grace.
Oh wow, what an honour. Whaftailava moliava noa. Thank you very much in the name of our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ, and a huge Pacific greetings from the centre of the universe, Te Wai Ponamu. And we don't come into these roles on our own or to be leaders or anything, but we are just here to serve. I would like to dedicate this award to my team back home. Not all of us could make it here tonight, but this is for our team and our community back in Waitaki. So, whaftai te lelava.
Recipient tonight has been an outstanding leader in hospitality and manaakitanga, particularly in managing one of New Zealand's managed isolation and quarantine system. He managed a team that helped keep Aotearoa safe. The Ministry for Pacific Peoples Pacific Community Leadership Award goes to David Latu.
Malo Elele, my name is David Latu. I'm proud Tongan. Mum's from Vava'u and dad's from Ha'apai. And I'm the hotel manager here at the Jet Park Hotel in Hamilton and have been for the last 3 years. Initially, when we got the call to become an MIQ, we didn't know what to expect. But then when the Ministry of Health came over to ask for assistance being an MIQ, the staff didn't walk away from the challenge. They wanted to face up and help the country through the process, which is really good. We had really good support from the Waikato Tainui. They had a Potiaki team which came and gave us the blueprint, which was the Waikato way. And that consisted of manaakitanga, kawea ake, and mahitahi. And I think this is where nurses, hotel staff, and the Defence Force came together to try and look after the guests themselves. Mum used to work at a rest home, so there was a lot of patience. And I think I've built that patience skill from her. The biggest thing for me was to let the staff around me express themselves. And like a lot of the initiatives that we ran wasn't just centred around sort of my ideas, it was a collective. And you know, everybody had an input into what we wanted to do throughout MIQ. I guess the biggest thing for us is we were part of the team that gave New Zealand time to react to the virus. We had the virus at the border for a very long time until, you know, we could vaccinate. the entire country. And that part of our contribution to the country is our duty to do so, and we're very, very proud of that.
First and foremost, I'd like to thank the Heavenly Father for bringing us here tonight, not only to celebrate Pacific Island success, but to highlight the great work that our Pacific people are doing in our country. I'd like to acknowledge the Minister and our dignitaries here tonight and continuing to be the voice of the Pacific people in New Zealand. COVID-19 was an unprecedented time for us all. What was even more extraordinary was New Zealand's response to the pandemic. This led to the birth of MIQ as part of the border protection against the virus. Over a 2-year period, an MIQ team of 4,000 looked after 230,000 returnees. I'd like to thank all the staff who worked in MIQ, MB, Defence Force, nurses, doctors, police officers, security guards, wellness navigators, and of course, our beloved hotel staff. As a unit, we stood firm on the front line, never wavering against an invisible enemy. We did this for our family, but most of all, our country. I accept this award on your behalf and dedicate it to you all. Tua eki, o whātu.
Mālo, David. Well, it has been a wonderful night celebrating our Pacific peoples who have made significant contributions to our communities. Tonight, we've honoured you for your service, tau tua mo te whakamaoni, your leadership, pole polenga lele I o me ko te takitaki alofa, and the legacy you've given our people, te olanga manuia.
A huge thank you goes out to the judging panel and our moderator. You know who you are, but if someone wants to know, I'm paid with KFC and I can tell you who they are and what table they're sitting on.
What a night it has been. Can we pour all our hands together for all of the amazing winners tonight?